Welcome back to The Ancient Path. I want to take a bit of a turn and look specifically at Genesis chapter 1, because I frankly think that this creation account often gets misinterpreted, and it makes living in a postmodern world much harder than it needs to be. If you want to understand what an author is trying to say, sometimes you need to know the questions that they are trying to answer. There's a pretty well-known debate today. Is the Bible true, or is evolution true? Did God create the universe, or is it just the product of a big bang? My personal thought is, if God spoke, couldn't that cause a big bang? I do believe that God could have used an evolutionary process to create the world around us. I'm not saying that that's how He did it, but I don't believe that the Bible is trying to argue against that, or argue against an evolutionary process. What the Bible is declaring is that all life has incredible value because it is all the creation of Almighty God. Even if God used an evolutionary process, life is not the product of random chance. Secondly, the Bible is declaring that all human life has unsurpassable worth because every single human, man, woman, child, elderly, even the unborn, are made in the image of God. We will look at that in greater depth in the next episode. But notice, here is the issue between Scripture and modern evolutionary theory. The issue exists in the idea of, does human life have sacred value, or is it just animalistic? If I believe that God created human life in His own image, then I will treat every human being as if their life is sacred. If, on the other hand, I believe that human life is not created by God, that it's just the product of random chance, then human life is just animalistic and can be treated like any other animal. If God used an evolutionary process to create our universe or not, I do not know. I don't believe the Bible is trying to argue for or against that. What I do believe is that the Bible tells us there is a God who is the Creator, and therefore, by whatever means God created the universe, He created it. It is the product of His design, and human life is sacred because human life is made in the image of God. The Bible is looking at who created the world. Science is looking at how it was created. They are trying to answer two very different questions. The Bible is revealing the nature of who is behind creation. It's not attempting to be a science textbook. Science is attempting to answer how God created it. It's not trying to reveal God, it's trying to unveil God's process. They are not in competition with one another, because they're not even trying to address the same issue. Any sense of competition between Scripture and science is humanly imposed. Genesis 1 is revealing the character and the nature of God. With that in mind, let's notice also something deeper in this passage. There is a correspondence between day 1 and day 4, between day 2 and day 5, between day 3 and day 6. On days 1, 2, and 3, God creates a habitation. On days 4, 5, and 6, God creates an inhabitant. Day 1, God creates light and darkness. Day 4, God creates sun and moon. Day 2, God creates sky and sea. Day 5, God creates birds of the air and fish of the sea. Day 3, God creates land. Day 6, God creates land animals and humans. The point is that Scripture is teaching us something deeper than science. It is teaching us that this one God Almighty loves us so much that He created a provision, a place to live, before He created anything else. He created a habitation, and then He creates an inhabitant. Before we are created, He creates for us a place, a provision, and a purpose. We're given a place, the Garden of Eden, a provision, plenty of food to eat, and a purpose. We are called to rule the world in His image. The Bible is a spiritual text, and it's primarily seeking to reveal the incredible, beneficent heart of God. That God's heart is so kind and so faithful, and in a word, so good.